Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Can someone shout, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Can someone shout, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can someone shout, hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord. Give it your hands together for the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on, put your hands together for the Lord. You can have a seat if you can. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This morning, indeed, it's another wonderful morning that we are in the presence of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And we know that in the presence of the Lord is fullness of joy, and in his right hand is pleasure forevermore. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Today we start service a little earlier today because today it's the last day of the last game of the World Cup. And we start service a little earlier so that folks can reach home on time to be able to enjoy the game. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This morning, I want to say, you know, may the best team win today.
Amen.
May the best team win today. But we are in the presence of the Lord this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are here to give God praise because he's worthy of all our praises. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord. You know, last week I was speaking to you on the right to judgment. And as we learned on last week that the right to judgment, it is the judgment for all those who will not abide in the things or acknowledge the righteousness of God even in this life. Amen.
Amen.
And you also learn that the right to judgment is a judgment to give man the opportunity to know where he went wrong. Praise the Lord. And we saw all the books that will be opened. And the Bible teaches that man will be judged out of those books. Praise the Lord.
Praise
that somebody we know that our God, he's a just God. Amen.
Yes.
Our God, he's a fair God. Amen.
Amen.
Our God, he's a righteous judge. Amen.
Amen.
My God, it is really surprising that man, and what is so surprising, you know, in the natural sphere of things, you know, I should say more or less, and human beings becomes fearful of things that will destroy them for eternity, amen.
Yes.
In the natural sphere of things, amen. But my God, we are living in a time when men no longer even care about what God can do or what he will do. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And it tells us that we are living and we are walking in the last days. Amen.
Yes.
People, my God, it is just like seeing fire, knowing that it is fire, and putting your hands in the fire. Amen. And you wonder, my God, what is happening in this time? People no longer care about their souls. Amen. But as the scripture teaches, what will it profit a man if he should gain the whole world and suffer the loss of his own soul? Amen. Or what could a man give in exchange for his soul? Believers, praise the name of the Lord this morning. I give God praise and thanks again for another opportunity that I can speak to you, hallelujah, about the timeline of God. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to know, praise the name of the Lord, whether the world like it or not, it is coming. Amen.
Amen.
Whether the world like it or not, hallelujah, we cannot change the plans of God. Amen.
Amen.
So my God, as I said to you on last week, that now is the time, hallelujah, for us to look up because our redemption drew nigh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You know, there is a question. And a question in the mind of many. And that question is where the saints of God will spend their eternity. Where the saints of God, where we, the children of God, will spend our eternity. You know, there is a theory. And that theory is that the saints are to spend eternity in heaven. But somebody, I want you to know, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah. Yes, we know, hallelujah, without any doubt, that the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ has promised, and he said, in my Father's house there are many mansions. He said, if it wasn't so, I would have told you. He said, I am going there to prepare a place for you. I'm going to come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Hallelujah. And we know that Jesus was speaking about things that he knew of. Hallelujah. Because, hallelujah, he was there. Hallelujah. My God, Jesus, hallelujah, he lived there. Hallelujah. And my God, he knew that in his Father's house there are many mansions. And he knew, hallelujah, that God prepared mansions there for the saints. Hallelujah. And I want you to know, hallelujah, my God, yes, there is a theory that we will live in the heavens all our life. But I want you to know the Bible don't really teach that. Hallelujah. Yes, we will go there. And yes, hallelujah, my God, we will have a dwelling place there. But somebody praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. As the Bible teaches, the meek will inherit the earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So with me, I want you to understand, hallelujah, yes, we will go to heaven. Yes, my God, we will live there. Hallelujah. Yes, praise the name of the Lord. We will live there. But I want you to understand God's objective. It is for us to inherit the earth. Hallelujah. Amen. My God, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. All the saints of God. Yes, hallelujah. When the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, hallelujah, comes back to take the church with him. Hallelujah. Yes, we'll be raptured with him. Hallelujah. To go with him in our mansions. Hallelujah. But I want you to understand, we'll also come back with him to inherit the earth. We'll also come back with him when the kingdom of this earth or the kingdom of this world shall become the kingdom of our God. Can somebody shout praise the Lord? You know, praise the name of the Lord. All saints will be translated and will stay in heaven until they return with Christ at the second coming. Can someone shout praise the Lord? So yes, we'll be translated. And we'll stay with Christ in heaven. Hallelujah. But somebody at the second coming of Christ, at the second, hallelujah, event, hallelujah, when Jesus is coming back, hallelujah, to this earth, hallelujah, to make this kingdom the kingdom of this world, the kingdom of our God. I want you to understand, we the saints will come back with him. Hallelujah. You know, Zechariah chapter 14 and verses 4 and verses 5, hallelujah, praise the Lord. I'm going to be running on a bit. Zechariah chapter 14 and verses 5, the Bible reads it, hallelujah, and he shall flee to the valleys of the mountains, for the valleys of the mountains shall reach unto Azel. Yea, he shall flee, like as he fled from before the earthquake, and in the day of Uzziah, king of Judah, and the Lord my God, and the Lord my God, and I want you to look at that, hallelujah, close it. And the Lord my God shall come, and he shall come, and all his saints shall come with him. And he shall come, hallelujah, and he shall come, and all the saints with him. Can someone say praise the Lord? Just somebody, what the writer is saying here, hallelujah. And what the writer is saying here in the book of Zechariah, the Bible, the writer is saying that when Jesus is coming back the second time, the saints of God will be coming with him. Can someone shout praise the Lord? Can someone shout, we are the saints of God? Can someone shout, we are the saints of God? Jude chapter 1 and verses 40, praise name of the Lord. Jude chapter 1 and verses 40. The Bible reads here, and Enoch also, the servant or the seventh from Adam, hallelujah. Enoch also, the seventh from Adam, prophesied of these, saying, behold, the Lord cometh with how many? With 10,000 of the saints. Can somebody say, praise the Lord? So somebody, hallelujah, praise the name of the Lord. I want you to know, hallelujah, yes, we will be translated. Yes, we'll be changed. Hallelujah. Yes, we'll be raptured to meet the Lord in the air. Yes, we will go to our mansions in heaven. Hallelujah. But somebody, hallelujah, we'll come back with the Lord. For the saints of God, we shall inherit the earth. Can somebody shout praise the Lord? Can someone shout praise the Lord? Can someone shout hallelujah? You know, my God, it is David who said in Psalms chapter 37 and verses 9. David said in Psalms 37 and verses 9, he said, for the evildoers shall be cut off. The evildoers shall be cut off. But those that wait upon the Lord, they shall do what? They shall inherit the earth. Hallelujah. Psalms chapter 37 and verses 9. Hallelujah. I'm reading again. David said in Psalms 37 and verses 9. Hallelujah. He said, the evildoers, they shall be cut off. But those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit what? The earth. Can someone shout praise the Lord? So David is saying, yeah, they even do us, they will be cut off. Come on, somebody. I want you to understand, we get worried and work up all the people who are doing evil. But the Bible said they will be cut off. Somebody, I want you to understand that there is a place already prepared for the devil. And somebody, all those who do evil at the devil, they also will inherit that place. But I want you to understand, the Bible also stated, as David said, they, hallelujah, they that trust in the Lord, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. Can someone shout praise the Lord? Also in verses 11 of the same chapter, verses 11 of the same chapter, David went on to say, he said, but the meek shall do what? Inherit the earth and shall delight themselves well in the abundance of peace. Somebody, I want you to understand, hallelujah, yes, hallelujah, God will take us out of this place, and God is going to renovate this earth, as the Bible teaches, and this earth will be renovated with fire. But somebody, hallelujah, when Jesus comes back, hallelujah, even with the, hallelujah, for that millennium period, that 1,000 years, I want you to understand, we will come back with the Lord, even as Jesus came back, hallelujah, to declare war against the enemy's war. I want you to understand, we will come back to the Lord. But somebody, hallelujah, we shall inherit the earth when Jesus, hallelujah, the kingdom of this world is going to become the kingdom of our God. Can someone shout praise the Lord? Can someone shout praise the Lord? You know, David in the same chapter, if you look at verses 18 of the same chapter, David said, the Lord knoweth what? The days of the upright, and their inheritance shall be for how long? The inheritance, that means, my God, David said earlier that the meek shall inherit. Our inheritance of the earth shall be forever. Yes, it was always the plans of God for us to live here in peace. It was always the plans of God for us to live here in happiness. Hallelujah. But somebody, I want you to understand, the day is going to come when God, hallelujah, is going to renovate this earth as it was in the beginning. So shall it be in the end. Hallelujah. The meek shall inherit the earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. The unrighteous will be cut off. My God, they do wrong and they feel great about it. They live their life anyhow and they feel good about it. But somebody, I want you to know, what did not happen in a million years will one day. The Bible teaches that my God, that Noah, my God, the man he preached, and the man preached, my God, for many years. The man preached for 100 years. But somebody, my God, nobody believed him. The man was preaching and letting them know that God is about to declare war upon the earth. He's about to pour his wrath upon the earth. Nobody listened to the man of God. Oh, I'm the man of God. He was saying to them, and rain is going to, it's going to rain on the earth, and the earth is going to flood, and every living thing that is upon the face of the earth will die. But nobody listened to him. But somebody, I want you to know that day came when it did rain and it did flood, and every living thing perished upon the face of the earth. Somebody, I want you to understand, hallelujah. Yes, God had purified the earth in that time so that the will of God, so that the plan of God, so that the purpose of God will exist upon his earth. Hallelujah. And somebody, he will do it again. But this time he will not do it with water. He's going to do it with fire. Somebody, I listen to him. You hear preachers, and preachers preach over and over again about God's plan for the earth. Oh, and my God, we let it go to one ear and come out to the other. But somebody, praise the name of the Lord. I come out here to let you know, my God, we are living in the final come down. Hallelujah. We are living in the final come down. Hallelujah. You know, David also said in Psalms, same Psalms 37, verses 29, and also verses 34. He said in 29, he said, the righteous shall inherit the earth. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell therein for how long? The righteous. My God, could someone say we are the righteousness of God?
We are the righteousness.
The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell in the land forever. Could someone say, praise the Lord?
Praise
so somebody, yes, hallelujah. We will go to our mansions. I want you to know, my God, the advantage that we have. It is, I'm saying we, that is those who are saved and living for Jesus. It is that, my God, hallelujah. It is that, my God, when we are being raptured, hallelujah, even before we are being raptured, our bodies will be changed from mortality to immortality. Amen. So that is the disadvantage we have. We will have that immortal body so that we, my God, can travel to from earth to our mansions and from our mansions back to earth. Hallelujah. The man who don't, my God, the man who did not allow himself the opportunity of going in the rapture, he will not have that body. Somebody, are you listening? So somebody, my God, that man will be waiting for the right throne judgment. Whether that man die and go to the grave, he will have a resurrection. There is a resurrection for every man, whether you live a good life or you live a bad life. But some will be resurrected unto life, and some will be resurrected unto eternal damnation or eternal death. Somebody, I said to you, what will it profit a man if he should gain this world and suffer the loss of his own soul? I want you to understand, hallelujah, and our advantage is that, my God, because we are living for Jesus, when you are living for Jesus, when you are living in righteousness, you are guaranteed an immortal body. You are guaranteed a heavenly body. Hallelujah. I told you, my God, both good and bad will receive wages.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. The Bible teaches that the wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life. A man can choose the wages of death, or he can choose the wages of eternal life. Can someone say,
praise the Lord?
Can someone say, praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
What can you do for man? The most you can do is lead them to the water. You cannot force them to drink it. They are free moral agents having the power of choice. Come on, somebody. And the most you can do is talk to them. But if they, come on, somebody, human beings, if they don't want to drink the water, they will stay there and die. Somebody, are you listening? But my God, the most you can do is lead them to the water. You don't have control of another human being life. And you don't have to have control of another human being life. Not even God. Come on, somebody. Not even God controls us. Somebody, are you listening? God don't control you. You are not like a puppet on a string. And when God pull your string, you move. God made you a free moral agent. And he gave you the power of choice. You can choose to live or you can choose to die. You can choose to be successful or you can choose not to be. Hallelujah. But somebody, I want you to know, hallelujah, that God has provided for you. Can someone shout praise the Lord? Can someone shout praise the Lord? Can see somebody after hallelujah. Oh God. Can someone shout praise the Lord? Can someone shout praise the Lord? After we come back with the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we shall then reign with him. We shall reign with him on the earth. Hallelujah. Look at Revelation chapter 20, verses 4 to 10. Revelation 20, verses 4 to 10. I'm reading one time. Revelation chapter 20, verses 4 to 10. And the John said it, and I saw thrones, and they sat upon them. And judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Christ and for the word of God, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their forehead or in their hand. And they live, and they live, and they live, and they live with who? And they live with who? With Christ. How long? 1,000 years. So somebody, my God, you're seeing those who obey the will of God. Those, hallelujah, who walk with God. Those, hallelujah, who walk in the righteousness of God. Hallelujah. You're seeing them here reigning with Christ for 1,000 years. You see, my God, after we come back and that millennium period, that period, hallelujah, of making sure that everything is right. What is this millennium period? Millennium period is making sure that it is right for our God, hallelujah, to set up his kingdom upon the earth, hallelujah, because God will not set his kingdom up upon this earth unless this earth is completely rid of sin, hallelujah. The millennium period is to get rid of rebels, hallelujah. Rebels, my God. Rebels, come on somebody. Rebels in our communities. Rebels in our world. Rebels in the church. Come on somebody. Who is a rebel? A rebel, my God, is those who war against the things of God. Those who war against, come on somebody. A rebel, come on somebody, is one who abides in sin. For sin is transgression against the laws of God. Somebody, are you listening to me? But the millennium is to get rid of these rebels. Somebody, I listen to me. Yeah. And oh yes, we will reign with him. And we will reign with him. Look at verses 5. And the rest of the dead, and the rest of the dead live not again until the what?
1,000 years.
The 1,000 years were finished. So it means I want you to understand, my God, hallelujah, the rest of the dead. Somebody, those who died in Christ, they reigned with him. Hallelujah. The rest of the dead, that is those who were out of Christ. Dear my God, they live not until the 1,000 years is over so that they can stand before the judgment throne of God so that God can give them, hallelujah, an insight of the life to live. And my God, and the days that they heard the preach of God, yes, hallelujah, and they did not obey the word of God. The Bible said, today, if you should hear the voice of God, harden your heart, hallelujah, you cannot go before the white throne and tell God that you never heard the word. God placed a preacher here who preached the word, amen.
Yeah.
You have no excuse. If you die now, you split hell open. If you die now and you die out of Christ, you split hell open. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But somebody, my God, you are left with no excuse. The Bible said, hallelujah, the dead, the rest of the dead. They live not again until the towns and the earth are finished. This is the first resurrection. Somebody, I hear me. Blessed and holy is he that had part in the what? The first resurrection. The first resurrection. On such the second death hath no power. But they shall be what? Priests of God and of Christ. And they shall do what? They shall reign with him for how long? For 1,000 years. Somebody, hallelujah. My God, we shall be the priests of God. We shall be, come on somebody, we shall reign with him. Hallelujah. Why? Because somebody, we obey God now. Hallelujah. Yes. So be that now. Come on somebody. You can live your life to people. You can live your life to people, but you can only do so much. Amen. Yes. You can talk to people, my God. Over the years of my pastoring and my ministry, I've seen, my God, many who you have ministered to, who you have counseled, who you have been there for, and been know the will of God, and yet still to go in the arms of the devil. Somebody, are you listening? I want you to understand, my God. Listen to me. You can only take them that far. Hallelujah. Take them to God. Nurture them in God. But I want you to know, don't hold yourself accountable or responsible for, my God, for their decisions. Hallelujah. Don't ever hold yourself responsible for their decisions. My God, they, hallelujah, will pay the price, hallelujah, for their decisions. Hallelujah. Whether the price is blessing or whether it is curse. Somebody, are you listening to me? Oh, hallelujah. Verses 7, hallelujah. And when the 1,000 years expire, Satan shall be what? Loose out of his prison. And shall go out and do what? Deceive the nations which are in the four quarters of the earth, God and my God, to gather them together for battle. Or to battle. The number of whom is as the sand of the sea. So I want you to understand, imagine that. You have a millennium period, a period of 1,000 years of getting rid of rebellions, of dealing with rebels. And yet still, my God, man, heart is so hard. A millennium period where Jesus is reigning with man. And then, my God, and the saints is there reigning with him, working to make sure that man know the purpose and the principles of God. And to make sure that, my God, of things is ready for the Father to set up his kingdom upon the earth. And somebody, my God, to the end of all of that, to the end of that 1,000 years, to the end of that 1,000 years, man still, my God, man still rise up and rebel again against God. Man still rise up, my God, to war against God. Somebody, are you listening to me? It means, my God, it shows the wickedness of the heart of man. Amen. Yes. It shows the evil of the heart of man. Amen. But my God, the Bible reads here, hallelujah, and Satan, when he's being loose, he began to gather men like the sand of the sea to rise up and to battle against God. But verses 9 said, and they went up on the breadth of the earth and compassed the camps of the whole of the saints above. They come up against us, hallelujah, and our Christ and the beloved city, and fire came down from God out of heaven and did what with them. And devour them. Hallelujah. See, my God, when we thought that they were fighting that battle with us, they were fighting that battle with the Almighty God. Amen. The Bible said fire came down from heaven and devoured them. Somebody, I want you to understand. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. We, the saints of God, hallelujah, will spend our eternity with Christ as the kingdom of this world become the kingdom of our God. Can someone shout praise the Lord? Can someone shout praise the Lord? Oh, hallelujah. Can someone shout hallelujah? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But my God, as I said to you, we will continue to live, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah. We are spending, hallelujah, our life reigning with the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, but we continue to live in the New Jerusalem in heaven until it is moved from heaven to the earth. So, my God, so what does that mean? It means, my God, we are reigning with Christ on the earth for this 1,000 years. Praise the Lord. But we have a celestial body. Hallelujah. We have, my God, we have, hallelujah, a heavenly body. And that heavenly body, hallelujah, we can be transported in the space of seconds from the earth, hallelujah, to, my God, to our mansions in the New Jerusalem. Can somebody say, praise the Lord? Can somebody say, praise the Lord? And somebody said, Pastor Cindy, I'm going to look at me in Revelation. Praise the name of the Lord, Revelation chapter. Look at me in Revelation chapter 21, verses 9. Revelation chapter 21, look at verses 2, and then we look at verses 9 and 10 here, and say amen. And I told you that the advantage that we have, it is that we come out somebody, it is precious for you to live for Jesus now, because if you're being left behind, I want you to understand, my God, you will not have the opportunity of an immortal body, hallelujah, to an immortal body to reign with God. Can someone say, praise the Lord? Can someone say, praise the Lord? I want you to understand that every human being will get a body. Whether you are in Christ or whether you are out of Christ, you're going to get a body. And I'm my God, when my God, those who are out of Christ, the dead, that my God, that remain in the grave after the first resurrection, I want you to understand that they will put on a body that will, my God, that will be tormented, my God, for eternity. Somebody, they will have a body, my God, that will be tormented in hell for eternity. Come on, somebody. And my God, hallelujah, the body that we will put on, it is a body so that we, hallelujah, can be transported, hallelujah, from earth to the New Jerusalem in the space of seconds. Can someone say, praise the Lord? Can someone say, praise the Lord? Oh, my God, hallelujah, praise the Lord, my God. The New Jerusalem, hallelujah, that is where our God dwells, amen. That is where the Father dwells. Can someone say, praise the Lord? And I want you to look at Revelation chapter 21, verses 2, and you read verses 9 and 10 also, you haven't seen that. And I just saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from where? From God out of the heavens, prepared as a what? As a bride, adorned for a husband. Can someone say, praise the Lord? So chant in verses 21, that is after the millennium period, my God, after the white tomb judgment, hallelujah, John saw the New Jerusalem, hallelujah, now coming down at dawn. Come on, somebody. She's coming down at dawn. She's coming down as a bride at dawn for her husband. It means, I want you to understand, after the earth is properly well purified, after the earth is properly well cleaned up, hallelujah, then, hallelujah, God is going to set up his kingdom here. Can someone say, praise the Lord? But somebody, hallelujah, those who are raptured in the rapture, hallelujah, we, hallelujah, will be living in the New Jerusalem as much as we are reigning in Christ on the earth. Amen. So we will live there for a time, hallelujah, until it come down. Can somebody say, praise the Lord? Because if it come down, hallelujah, we don't need, my God, to go in and up there anymore, because it is now set up on the earth. Can somebody say, praise the Lord? So, my God, so you're seeing here, John is seeing here, and I just saw the holy city, the New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of where? Out of where? Heaven, and it was prepared as a bride adorned for a husband. Can somebody say, praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
My God, praise the Lord. I want you to understand, hallelujah, my God, what we will be doing. And you will realize that my wife and I are going in that direction. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We want you to understand prophecies. Can someone say, praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
We want you to understand the blueprint of God. And somebody, praise the name of the Lord. It will help you to grow, to understand, praise. You see, I want you to understand, hallelujah, you ought to know where it started and where it will end. Can someone say, praise the Lord? You see, we say, as it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. But my God, do we understand how it was in the beginning? And do we understand, hallelujah, how it will be in the end? I want you to know, hallelujah, it is given to you for you to know, amen? You are the children of the day and not the children of the night. Can someone say, praise the Lord? Can someone say, praise the Lord? I said, the reason why I was telling you, when you miss a service, my God, you can miss so much. Come on, somebody. Can someone say,
praise the Lord?
Can someone say, praise the Lord? I told you we are looking at 9 and 10 also. Look at 9 and 10. Praise the name of the Lord. 9 and 10. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. 9 and 10. You haven't seen that? And there came unto me one of the 7 angels, which had the 7 vials full of 7 last what? Plagues. And talked with me, saying, come hither. I will show thee the bride of the Lamb's wife. And he carried me away in the spirit to a great high mountain. And he showed me that great who? City, and that city was who? The holy Jerusalem. Descending where? Out of the heaven from God. Can someone say, praise the Lord? So my God, hallelujah. You're seeing, hallelujah. You're seeing Jerusalem. You're seeing that holy city now descending from the heavens of God and coming to be set up on the earth where we the righteous shall inherit it. Can someone say, praise the Lord? Can someone say, praise the Lord? So somebody praise the name of the Lord, my God. It is, hallelujah, of significant advantage for us, hallelujah, to make it in the rapture of the church. Can someone say, praise the Lord? It is of significant advantage for you to be in the first resurrection. Can someone say, praise the Lord? If you're not in the first resurrection, it means you didn't live for Jesus. Come on, somebody. If you're not in the first resurrection, it means, my God, you compromise your salvation. Amen. Amen. You don't compromise your salvation. Whatever you do, let it be. Come on, somebody. As human beings, we will make mistakes. Amen. As human beings, we will falter. Come on, somebody. But when you falter, you have, my God, you have, hallelujah, you have that, my God, that throne of mercy that you can go to. Hallelujah. You can go before the Lord and ask for forgiveness. Come on, somebody. But you don't falter and continue to live doing the wrong things and happy about doing the wrong things and expect to go to heaven. Come on, somebody. You know, my God, hallelujah. There is an old saying, everybody want to go to heaven, but nobody want to die. And somebody, my God, I'm not speaking of that dying and just quitting the state of action. But you got to die yourself to make it to heaven. Hallelujah. Jesus said, any man that must come after me, he must first learn to do what? To deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Can someone say, praise the Lord? Oh, can someone say, thank you, Jesus? Oh, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. You see, I told you that we, the saints of God, we will go back and forth from heaven and earth during the millennium. Then we will live eternally with God in the new earth. Come on, somebody. I told you that just now. Amen? Praise the Lord. But I want you to praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. You see, I want to cut this in two. So because of time and I want to release you as early as possible this morning. Praise the Lord. Look at me in Revelation 21 verses 22. Praise the name of the Lord. Because we ought to support, we ought to back up what we are saying to you in the scripture. Amen? If you cannot support what you're saying in scripture, then it's better you hush your mouth. Amen? Can someone say, praise the Lord? Can someone say, praise the Lord? It must not be Pastor Simple speaking, but the word of God must be speaking through Pastor. The Bible.